why you need to stop discounting your services. Guys, Kim here from Your Social Voice. Now, today I want to talk to you about why you need to stop discounting your services, right? Everyone's seeing those ads on TV, they've heard them on the radio, you've seen them down the street where everything must go, prices are slashed, closing down sale, 50% off everything. Now, you don't want your business to be like that. I know every time I go to buy a rug, I just wait to see the next radio ad because I know I'm going to hear that someone's closing down even though they've been there for 10 years and they'll be there for 10 more. Now, why would you not want to discount, right? Because sometimes we think, well, that's the way for us to get businesses. That's the way for us to get business in. That's the way for us to grow our business. Isn't that how we should be doing things, right? Shouldn't we offer discount value for our clients? Now, I'll tell you a little bit what I think you should do instead and the reason why I wouldn't do that. But I'm gonna share with you a little bit of a story first about a company called Salesforce.com. I've just been listening to their book recently on Audible, Behind the Cloud. Phenomenal book. And one of the things they talked about is that they didn't want their salespeople to discount, right? Because what they were finding is that people getting to the end of their month, the salespeople, they were going through their processes, going through calling all their clients, and what they would do to meet their quota is at the end of the month, if they haven't got someone on yet, they would offer them a discount package and they would bring them on board. Now, you're probably sitting there thinking, well, hang on, if we get more clients on board, isn't it okay to discount? Isn't it okay to give them a discount? Short answer, no, right? That's why you shouldn't be doing it. What they found was people that were given a discount had a lower perceived value of the service and therefore were more prone to cancellations. And because they're on a month-to-month service, it really just dropping off the radar because they're given a discount, because they didn't see the value in the normal price of the product, which also means that you can't ever put your price back up. Right? Because if they've got it at a discounted price, that's what the price always is. Or if you always discount, if you have other products and services, you have other things for them to purchase from you, right? You have a value ladder where when people come in, they purchase something, then they purchase something else, and then something else again. They want a discount on all of them because you've conditioned them to do so. Now, from a psychological perspective, when we look at the psychology of sales and things like that, when it comes to giving someone a discount, you're bringing someone in that already has a lower perceived value of what you have because you haven't been able to show them the value in what it is that you have to offer. So if you do services, if you do coaching or anything like that, and one of my good friends, Alex Moskow, I did a video on this the other day, was that by discounting your products and services, you're bringing in those clients. And what happens is they're more likely to complain. They're more likely to ask for refunds. They're more likely to cancel. They're more likely to miss payments because you're bringing in someone who has a lack mindset. You're bringing in someone who doesn't believe that there's an abundance out there. And then of course I'm going to pay for your services in full. They have a lack mindset because they're going, I need to hang on to everything. I need a discount on this. And they're not willing to pay the full price. Now, look, I understand that sometimes in certain industries, discounts happen. Maybe you're in e-commerce and you do coupon codes and things like that. However, my preference, what I would prefer for people to do, and what I personally see as a bonus, is to add value, to give something extra, to sweeten the deal, to sweeten the pot. Because to me, I then still see the full value there, but if I get a little something bonus, that's great. But I still know that I paid the full price for that. A company that's done that tremendously well was Koala Mattresses. So if you're watching this internationally, I don't know if they've reached internationally yet. They're definitely big here in Australia. But they have those mattresses where you can jump on them. There's a video of the guy sitting there and the girl jumping and there's a glass of wine. It doesn't spill. I watched this video, right? I watched the video and I was like, oh, I was about to buy a new mattress. I didn't. I was like, nah, I'm not going to worry about them. Not going to choose them. Waited for a little while and it kept coming up and I was like, oh, actually $900 including shipping, I think it was. I was like, that's pretty decent. Like, that's not bad, but I'll leave it. Oh, I'll sort that out later. That's something for the future. Then what happened was I saw the same campaign that they were running, $900 including shipping with a free bottle of wine. That tipped me over the edge, that free bottle of wine. I was like, great, actually. Yeah, I may as well take advantage of this now. The price is still the same. I still paid $900, but all they had to do versus someone else who maybe would have given $100 off or $50 off, they probably gave me what might be a $10, $20 bottle of wine, but as well, because the ad had a wine glass in it, the people were jumping and it wasn't spilling over. I was like, great, actually, I like red wine. I'll get a bottle of that. So I took that offer up. They didn't give me a discount. I didn't ask for a discount. I took it, I did their 180-day sleep guarantee or whatever it was. And I was like, yep, cool, this is great. And I had no questions to ask them. I didn't ever ask for a refund. I didn't send it back to them. Even though my girlfriend didn't really like the bed, she said it was a little bit uncomfortable for her. I was like, nah, cool, don't worry about it, it's good. Like, we could have sent it back, but I said no. So think about any time that you've brought someone into your business that has caused a problem, or you haven't really got along with, or that's wanted a refund, or that's gone out there and said, oh, I need to cancel, or anything like that. Did you give them a discount? Right? Think about that. Did you give them a discount? Because most of the time, and I'm being general here, but it's because I'm trying to drive home this point. Most of the time, it is because you have discounted them. They've come in with a lack mindset. They don't see the value in it. And I believe if you think that what you have has value, there's no reason why you should discount it, right? You can give them something else. You can give them a bonus. You can give them something extra. But let's just say that you have a coaching package for $5,000 and you really want to get someone in and you go, look, I want to give you a bonus. Like, I want to give you a discount. If you take action with me today, I'm going to knock this down to $3,000 for you. This is an example Alex shared with me. I'm going to knock this down for $3,000 for you. When they come in, they don't have $5,000 worth of value in their mind. They know that you are willing to give and you're willing to give them a $2,000 discount, right? So you're willing to be flexible. And you most of the time find that they are the clients that cause the problems for you. Now, a great book, I think I have it here. I don't know if I have, but it's about being inflexible. Right, that inflexibility. So they talk about that because sometimes you're like, oh, you know, you need to be flexible with clients and things like that. It was the story that was honing in and it was hammering home this point was that those that are most successful are inflexible. They have boundaries, they have set ways that they do things, they don't discount, and they will not change that at all, right? They will not change that at all. So an example of that, right, that was shared, there's a multi-billion dollar CEO of a company. What he would do is that he said that every night his inflexibility was that I am home by 6 o'clock to have dinner with my kids, right? I'm home by 6 o'clock to have dinner with my kids. Doesn't matter if he had to stay up till 4 a.m. after the kids went to bed. He made sure that he was home every day at 6 to do that. Warren Buffett, his inflexibility is that you have one opportunity to pitch him. Warren Buffett doesn't discount. Right? So if you have a business idea or opportunity, or if you have a company you want to take and you want to get invested in by Berkshire Hathaway, you have one opportunity, you bring him your best deal, that's it. If he says no, you don't get to pitch again. Right? If someone of that magnitude is inflexible, do you think anyone goes, oh, actually, Warren, give me an extra 5%, please? Right? He's not discounting. He's not discounting. And again, I'm not saying that you can't do deals, right? For example, if you have an event on, you might have a VIP ticket and a general admission ticket. That's not discounting, you have two different tickets. And what you may do is an incentive for people, instead of discounting the VIP, maybe you get them to take a general ticket and you give them an upgrade to VIP. But they still see the value in it. You're not going there and you're not trying to push and fight and shove, because what happens is people automatically, you bring them in that have a scarcity mindset and you bring in those people that don't really value it. Because if it's a couple hundred bucks or even a couple thousand bucks, we can all go out and find that, right? We can go out there and create money. It's quite easy if you know what you're doing in your business to go out there and be able to generate that, generate inquiries, generate leads and bring money in, right? Simple, but not easy, I should say, right? So if it was easy, we'd all be millionaires. But the process is simple to be able to do that. So if we can do that, why can't other people do that for us? For me, I don't ask for a discount. Do I always try and get the best deal possible for me? Yes, right? But if I go to a hotel, I don't go, hey, give me 50% off the room. I'm like, cool, what can you do for me? Can you upgrade me? Can you include breakfast? Can you do me a deal like that? Where I still value them in full. If you went to a hotel, the Ritz-Carlton, and you paid a dollar to go in the room, you wouldn't value it. But if you pay $500 a night and then you get included in their club and you get breakfast included, snacks, all this sort of stuff, drinks and whatnot, you put a way higher perceived value on it and you still pay the full amount. You're still happy, they're happy, everyone wins. And that is why today I really wanted to hone in for you guys that you should not be discounting your services. You should not be slashing prices. You should not be giving discounts. Either add more value or look at your sales strategy. That's the two prescriptions, because if you don't have an effective sales strategy, you think you have to use discounts to do it if you sell services or anything like that, right? Or you need to look at the value that's in there. If the client doesn't see it, maybe you need to include something else, or you need a more effective sales strategy. It depends on the two. I can't tell you which one it is for you, but if you want to, drop a comment down below. If you need help with this, please feel free to reach out. More than happy to help. Give us a little thumbs up if you like this video as well. And as always, please subscribe so that you can see this video first before anyone else gets their hands onto it. Until next time, guys, I'm Kim Barrett. You've all been awesome. Adios.